G'day and welcome back to Build Some and presentation 22 in the series on the timber frame code, or AS 1684, and in this one we're going to look at our top plates. So the rules associated with top plates are rule 6.2.2.1 and 6.3.4, and the table we're going to use for my example that we're using is table 15. So rule 6.2.2.1 says the top plates shall be provided along the full length of all walls, including over openings. And there's a bit more about bottom plates, but we'll look at that next. The size of top plates for single story or upper story of a two story construction shall be determined from span table 15 and 16 of the supplements, respectively, for sheet and tile roofs. So sheet roofs, table 15, tile roofs, table 16. If you need top plates for the lower story of two-story construction, then you need span table 46. And there's a note there that wall plate sizes in the span tables are appropriate for wall plates supporting defined roof loads located in any position along the length of the plate. Rule 6.3.4 says that top plates may be a minimum of 35 millimetres deep multiplied by the width of the stud for any stress grade. So in other words, if your stud's 70, then your bottom plate obviously has to be 70. If your stud's 90, then your bottom plate obviously has to be 90. They are not required to resist wind uplift forces, as where rafters or trusses are nominally fixed or where tie down spacing is zero. See note 7 in span table 15 and 16, and loads from roof trusses, rafters, floor joists and similar members are located directly above studs or at or within 1.5 times the depth of the plate from the stud. So if you can guarantee that any roof truss, rafter, floor joist is going to land within 1.5 times the depth of the top plate from the stud, then you can just use a minimum of 35 mil. Alright, 70 by 35 in our case. That's a given. Alright, if you can guarantee everything's going to land in that sort of region. Top plates fully supported on masonry walls shall be determined from the span tables, assuming a stud spacing of 300 millimetres and a tie down spacing equivalent to the tie down spacing of the plate. And double or multiple top plates, known as ribbon plates, may be used provided the allowable roof load width is determined in accordance with the span tables for members indicated as being made up of multiples. So two 35 by 70s or two 38 by 75s. That's obviously there's multiples plates in there. So here's our span table, table 15, top plates, sheet roof, and obviously you'd have to make sure it's for the right timber species. We have to look at the rafter spacing, so ours is 600. We bring this up, our truss joist rafter spacing 600, so we're obviously going to use this column. And our tie down spacing, so if we're going to tie our top plate down to our wall, and the standard spacing for that's 1200, so we'll use 1200. And we can see here our stud spacing is 600. Okay, so you have to use a 70 by 35 mil top plate. That's how it works. Even if our tie down spacing was 600 or 900 or even zero, it's not going to change. We're using a 35 by 70 mil member. The reason it's written backwards like that is because they always put the height first. So because the top plate's essentially on its flat, so 35 mil high, 70 mil wide. Okay, so 35 by 70 is our top plate, and there we go. We've worked out the top plate size of the top plate that we need for this particular job.